Hi everyone, and welcome to the Get Started with Sheetgo series. My name is Valentin, and I'm going to guide you through our Sheetgo product, what a connection is, how you can create one, which different connection types we have, and of course our different features. Today I'll show you how to filter data with Sheetgo. A Sheetgo connection brings data from a specific tab in a source sheet to a tab in a destination sheet. And with Sheetgo filters, you can specify exactly which data to transfer instead of the entire tab. We have three different filter types. First of all, there's the filter by condition. This is the quick and easy way to filter your data set based on specific criteria of specific columns. With our filter by query feature, you can create more complex filters and only select specific columns to transfer to another spreadsheet. And then lastly, our filter by color feature allows you to transfer data based on a specific background color of your cells. In this video, I'll show you how to filter by condition. So you define one or more conditions that you want your source data to match before you send it out to another spreadsheet. So you filter based on conditions of specific columns in your data set. If you want to filter your data based on multiple conditions, there's two options, the AND condition type or the OR condition type. But let me show you in practice. As you can see in this spreadsheet, I have all of our issues reported here. For this example, I want to send out the high priority box, so this is what we find in column E, only to Dominic to fix. So I want to create a spreadsheet, especially for Dominic with the high priority box that he needs to fix ASAP. So let me show you how you can do that with Sheetgo. As you can see here in Sheetgo, I've selected my issue tracker as my data source, so we want to filter out this data to Dominic's spreadsheet. So click continue, and then we enter the filter section. Here we choose, of course, the filter by condition, and since we want to filter based on two criteria, so the box needs to have a high priority, and the person that needs to fix them needs to be Dominic. So in this case, we need to choose between the AND or the OR condition type, but I want both of them to be valued as true. So they need to be high priority and assigned to Dominic. So we're going to keep it on AND condition type. And then here we select the column, of course, column E priority. Here we have all the different criteria options, but of course it's a text type. So we're going to say text is exactly high. There we go. And now we're adding the next condition. Who needs to fix these bugs? Text is exactly Dominic. There we go. Press continue to move on to the next step, and that is selecting your data destination. So where do we want to send this data to? Dominic could be working in Google Sheets, Excel, or wants to receive a CSV file. But for this example, I'll quickly send it to a Google Sheets file. It can be an already existing one that you can find in your drive, or you can let Sheetgo create a new file for you. We're going to do that in this example. Rename the file name to Bugs Dominic, for example. And you can also rename the tab. This is also the name of your Sheetgo connection. So, for example, I'll just put here High Priority, so that Dominic knows where this data comes from and what he needs to do with it. We're clicking Done Editing, and here you can see the overview of how your connection will look like. We're bringing in data from the issue tracker Google Sheets. We're filtering it with a filter by condition. I'm bringing the filtered data to another Google Sheets file that's meant to be for Dominic. Click Finish and Save to save your filter by condition connection. There we go. As you can see, you have a spreadsheet, Bugs Dominic, and Sheetgo has created the high priority tab in it, and Dominic has now all the information that he needs with the high priority bugs that he needs to fix ASAP. So the filter by condition has only brought the high priority bugs that need to be fixed by Dominic. One last thing to mention, the date and time format is off, as you can see. Simply change this back to date. And from now on, you'll have the correct format in your file. You share this with Dominic, and then he, of course, can start working on the bugs. Now, this is how you use Sheetgo's filter by condition. If you have any questions about this, please do not hesitate to contact us at any time. Thank you very much.